Hello, good evening. This is kickoff. Unusual, isn't it? I'm not dressed in the usual kickoff attire as we do because tonight we're coming to you from the comfort of a Black Stars player, one who has played in many Cup of Nations tournaments and has so many caps for the Black Stars team, one who spent more than a decade playing for the Black Stars team. Tonight we get the opportunity of speaking to him about everything, about his career moves at club level and ahead of the Africa Cup of Nations and another participation by the Ghana team. I'm not sure there's any who is more authoritative on how Ghana can perform in the 2015 Africa Cup of Nations in Equatorial Guinea, a tournament which starts a little over 20 days from now. He played in Equatorial Guinea just about 2 years ago, so he knows all about playing in that part of Africa. So we'll do a quick break. Kickoff is proudly sponsored by Bullet Energy Drink, Energy on Target. Tonight we'll do everything from here, so stay tuned. Welcome back from the break. Kickoff is on Metro TV, proudly sponsored by Bullet Energy Drink, Energy on Target. Tonight, we're bringing the show to you from the comfort of an outstanding defender in the history of football in this country and on the African continent, largely. One who's played in major leagues in Europe. He's joining us for kickoff tonight. My guest is JP4, John Paintsil. John, thank you very much for your time. And thank you for allowing us into your home. You have a perfect home.
Thank you.
It is my dream that by the time I get to your level, when I also play for the Black Stars for a long time, I can acquire something like this. Thank you very much. And Merry Christmas to you and a Happy New Year. We look forward to a brighter year in 2015.
Thank you very much.
Just briefly, your message, a good year or New Year message to the fans who are watching you. It's been a while since they saw you on television like this.
It's true. I mean, Merry Christmas and Happy New Year to all Ghanaians. God has been good to all of us. If I'm not lying, I mean, as far as you are alive, you breathe, you wake up, you sleep, you eat, that means God is with us. May this new year be all our year and then bring success, riches, money, whatever we are looking for in our life, God should provide. And please be prayerful. Everything is possible. In Jesus' name. Amen.
Amen. Thank you very much. So that's John Paintsil there, bringing that side of him. I mean, he's the one who often leads the prayer when the Black Stars team travels anywhere to play anything. Anytime they are together, he's the pastor of the team. So I'm not surprised. John, it's good to see you again. Welcome home.
Thank you.
You are home on holidays.
Yes.
Just briefly, I know you'll be going back very soon.
Yeah.
So how is life in the PSL in South Africa? You moved to Santos, subsequently to Maritzburg United. I watch you on my TV regularly.
Yes, God has been good. Life in South Africa, when it comes to football or soccer, they said it's been good. The fans are making everything possible for the game to suit each and everyone. And the referees officiate, it's been good. You know, before in Africa, when you play in African League, you know when you're going to play away game, you should expect yourself. I mean,
you should lose.
Yes. But there, I mean, whether you're playing at home or away, it's always tough. So, I always compare it to the European leagues. I think in the near future, South African League will be on top 10. In the world.
Wow.
Yeah, that's how I'm seeing it.
That's how fast it is improving.
Yeah, now it's improving, and then the TV wide, everything is, I mean, moving well.
And you know, you are a big name player, one of the headline names of the PSL. To many, we didn't expect you to move to the South African Premier League. There are those who are saying, are we sure the South African leagues, the South African clubs can pay John Paintsil? This is somebody who played top European football in the English Premier League, for instance, in Israel and other parts of the world. Is any South African club able to pay John Paintsil to play in the PSL?
As you can see, now I'm playing for South African team, Isbe United, and what they are doing now, it makes me happy. Okay. In football, sometimes, money is important in football when you're playing, but also when you're happy and you're playing is good. But I can say that what I'm achieving, what I'm having in the team, or what I have in the team now makes me happy. That's giving joy to perform, to do my duty when I'm on the field. Mm. And there's a lot of clubs that can also pay many players that play in Europe. Okay. There's money in the league, but now the league is new, and they are trying to also bring new professionals in, because each and every team has a right to sign only 5 foreigners.
Okay.
And when it comes to money, they do well. They pay monthly.
Are they able to pay you?
Yeah, they are paying me. I can't complain about that. I'm very, very happy with the contract they give me, and they respect my contract each and every month. So, and there's more to give, because when the player is happy, the more he plays good.
So you are happy in the South African Premier League?
Yeah, very happy.
And they are treating you well?
They are treating me well.
And it's not just the PSL. You have big television platforms that are making use of your experience over the years. You must be having fun in general there in South Africa.
Yeah, I think when it comes to Ghanaian players, let me use the opportunity to say thanks to the South Africans. They respect Ghanaians a lot.
Wow.
Yeah, especially they always bring up during the World Cup 2010, and they were calling us Bagana Bagana when South Africa were out from the tournament. So, and they respect each and every Ghanaian player that comes around their country. So, I mean, sometimes SuperSports invite me to come over for me to share my experience, how Ghanaians are doing, how did we end up, I mean, playing well during the World Cup, because they also want their team to do
what we have been
and
doing.
Now you can see South African League has gone up, and to also play more impact in their national
team. Is picking up very well.
We'll
get into that aspect of the conversation, where Ghana looks forward to playing against South Africa. I know if you are not supporting Ghana in the tournament, probably you may support South Africa, because that is where you play. Let's get on with it. You are in South Africa now, and they are using your image and your experience over the years to market the league and to, as it were, get the young guys to learn from you. But Ghana needs the same thing. Would you consider playing any role at all in the Ghana Premier League before you finally hang up your boots, before you finally quit football? There are those who say, maybe John and people like you who have played football to the highest level must also think of coming home one day to play a bit part role in getting the Ghana Premier League to a certain level, not just building for other people, but how about ours?
Yeah, I think it's important, the points that you made right now. It's always good for we, the senior players who have played in Europe. I mean, before we hang up our boots, coming home to also play for our club. I mean, even not our club, some clubs in Ghana, to also teach the young ones. Because in South Africa, always these boys come to me to ask questions. How did I make it to the top? So if we come back in and start playing, they also come to us. We can advise them, what to do, what not to do in your football career, and that things that will help the young ones. For me, I will say yes. I will definitely come back and play a team in Ghana before I hang up my boots.
You will do that?
I will do that.
How many years are we looking at?
I won't be long, because now I still feel fresh.
You still feel
fresh? Yeah, I'm not feeling like a player who is 33 getting to 34, because I work so hard. Because when a player start playing, first 15 minutes, if you start getting tired, that means you should know that
you should know that the time is
there. Yeah.
But drawing closer.
Right now, I haven't felt that yet.
Okay.
And always my coach, Steve Compera, he always used me as an example for the players, which I'm very, very proud of it. And that also keeps me work so hard.
Wow.
Yeah. So. Yeah, it won't be long.
You
short,
come home.
Short and long, I will come back home too.
So which will be your preferred team if you come back home? You want to play for which one? Liberty, Hearts of Oak, Kotoko? Because did I hear your father anyway said he'll prefer his son to play for Hearts of Oak or something. I don't know.
Yeah, that was years back. Yeah. But there's three teams in my mind that Brikum Arsenals, Liberty Professionals, and then the third one, I'm not going to mention it. So,
yeah. You mentioned the third one.
Yeah, I'll mention it.
But your father has a wish.
Yeah. I mean, he said that, but it's up to you, the player, and how you feel. Yeah, but sometimes too, fathers wish. Sometimes, you know, when especially when you're finishing, you just give the wish to your dad.
You give the wish to your dad to see how it goes.
We'll see how it goes.
So surely we should see John Paintsil come to play for gratis, not necessarily for the money, but
to
bring back some experience to share with the young people who are coming up.
You're right.
Okay. John Paintsil is my guest on Kickoff tonight. Kickoff is not following the usual, with a tie and everything, because we're doing this from the comfort of John Paintsil's home, one who's played in several Cup of Nations tournaments. We'll get into the AFCON bit because the tournament is coming up soon. John is not in Avram Grant's 31-man squad that will be preparing for the Cup of Nations in a few days' time from Seville in Spain. But he has experience playing at the highest level. We'll be sharing some of them with us. Kickoff is proudly sponsored by Bullet Energy Drink, Energy on Target. So let's get back to talking. John, so yeah, Cup of Nations is coming up. I know you've been in town, you've been in touch with the players. They are getting ready for camping. Is it 5 or 6 Cup of Nations tournaments? It's
six
tournament. 2002, 2006, 2008, 2010, 2012, and 2013. That's a record in Africa. You know that.
Yes.
Yeah, it's incredible. Another Cup of Nations is coming. The last one, you were there. How do you feel that this one you may not play in, or you won't play in Equatorial Guinea? How are you feeling?
Yeah, I mean, it's normal. You feel a bit disappointed, like you're working so hard in your team, expecting yourself to be called up. But
were you expecting to be called up? Because, I mean, obviously, you've played consistently this season.
I wasn't expecting, but I was looking forward to get my call back.
Wow.
Since I was playing consistent every week and week. But I also have to respect those who has been called to also represent the country. And these names that came up, I think none of them that you can say
they can
play at first 11. All of them, and then at the end of the day, it's only 18 players that will be dressing to represent the country. So for me, I always want to stay as a professional, because being a professional is not about putting your hand in your back and trying to be yes, but also respect your colleagues, and then because humility is your most important thing in our game. So what I can say is that I'll wish the boys well, because sometimes there might be a new coach that will prefer John to come in and play, and sometimes coaches also see different things, like, okay, I think I want to work with this player, I like the style of him, the way he played. So it's not about anything personal or anything. For me, I never judge coaches.
You never judge, so. As for humility, I know you have that a great deal. Do you look forward to making a return into the Black Stars team? Because it's been your home for more than 10 years.
Yeah, sure. I mean, I'll keep working. Anytime the time comes, I'm ready, because Ghana is my country, and I always have to do well for the country. Anytime, anyhow, they call me, I'm ready to come and serve the country.
Wow. You are not done paying, or you are not done servicing the Black Stars team, are you?
Yeah, I feel like there's more to give. Yeah, since like I said earlier on, my engine tells me that I can go more.
You can go more,
because if you look at
the JP engine,
well, the JP engine is still running. So you're still on.
Okay, now we have from 2002, as a young man who played in the FIFA Youth World Cup in Argentina, graduated into the Black Stars team, played in the Cup of Nations in Mali, a disappointing tournament without a doubt. In 2004, we failed totally to qualify. In 2006, another disappointing tournament. In 2008, when many expected that you guys had come of age and you had gained some amount of experience so you could deliver the trophy finally. We failed to do that. In 2010, when it was a mixed bag of mostly young players and few experienced players like yourself and maybe Asamoah Gyan, the team went very far and only lost narrowly to Egypt in the final. In 2012, we expected, okay, this team should win it this time because a lot of the experienced players have returned to the squad. We couldn't do it. In 2013, we all said, okay, 31 years, we should do it. We didn't do it. We have grown tired of always saying, oh, the next one. Oh, the next one. 33 years, January 2015, we're still pushing to win the Cup of Nations. What must we do differently if we're to win the tournament in Equatorial Guinea?
It's a big question. But I'll manage to put things together.
Yeah, yeah.
When I started playing for Black Stars, that was 2002, my first Nations Cup in Mali. It was rough in the national team in terms of sponsorship for the country. Welfare in general was a bit bad, let me put it that way. And 2004, which we couldn't qualify to go. 2006, we did qualify in Egypt. Mm. It's the same thing. Sponsorship, that was when Puma was coming in. And things wasn't okay, but that was where I saw that the team is moving forward. That's where the new football association, GFA, tried to recruit people in. Then from there, we start playing the Cup of, was it World Cup qualified?
Yes.
To Germany
2006. Yeah.
Yeah. And sponsorship came, bonuses was increased, and management is talking to players, asking them what they want. And every player wants comfort. If I'm playing for you and you're not there for me, I don't feel
there's no way I can give off my best.
Yeah. But GFA chairman and his people were doing that, going around, speaking to the players, called each and everyone, asking the problem in the team. So we also feel okay to express our view and what we want in the team, which they did that. And from that 2006, the team was on top.
Yeah.
We were playing very well. We
began to rise at a certain level.
And then 2010, we hit it hard during the World Cup, and we almost get to the final. So those managerial thing, I think I'll pick from 2006 and 2010. That managerial thing has to come in this tournament. If that feeling comes to come, I don't think the team will go to Equatorial Guinea return without the trophy. Wow. Because motivation always counts. No matter how much, it doesn't matter how much you're giving to the players or how much you are spending. Because some of the countries are also fighting to motivate their players. But
so it's not the money?
It's not about the money. It's about motivation. Because
so it's about the tit-a-tit. It's about
the connection between.
So you feel that we have not done that very well for some time now? You don't think that the officials
after 2010, after 2010, I think things become rough. This
lax a bit.
Yeah, a bit relaxing. Mm. So when a player sees that, saying that there's nothing going on, so doesn't have to be necessarily one person going up and then talk to the players, but all
it
the
has
time
to be the whole
team has to be there.
Okay.
And then because like. Fred Papo will always come to your room. Kwesi Nantechi will come to your room and talk to you. But later on, we saw different faces coming in. From my experience, I saw a lot of things that some management comes and then they have their own players to talk to. Oh, and others okay. says, for me, I'm experienced. I don't. Sometimes
you don't mind.
I don't mind. But some,
but
of,
maybe
the
young
some
player.
Of the young ones, it kills them. You always have to keep all of them together. It doesn't matter whether I played for Liberty Professionals or Kotoko. When you come, keep everyone equal. Don't go to one person's room, talk to the person, and then leave. You understand what I mean? Mm. So 2006, 2010, it was like it was
perfect.
It was compact. Yeah.
But then after the 2010 World Cup, you realize that the things you did
about,
that brought
yeah.
you success, we stopped doing
yeah,
them.
Yeah, we stopped doing that. So
for you, going into Equatorial Guinea 2015, we need to bring back that spirit
of
encouraging everybody. Yeah. It's not just about the money.
It's not about money. It's not about players. Players don't play football. It's a team.
It's a team?
Yes, it's a team.
Wow.
Team that played will always bring success. You can't just go there, I have players. No. But you must go as a team.
As a team?
Yes. So if you go as a team, and I mean, being humble and hungry, you will be successful.
This is an incredible revelation by John Paintsil. Played in 6 Africa Cup of Nations tournaments with the Black Stars team. Is a record in Ghana's football history, and even on the African continent. The records we had in the past, the likes of Samuel Eto'o and Rigobert Song, playing in 5 Africa Cup of Nations tournaments. John Paintsil has done 6. And he says he looks forward to making a return into the Black Stars team because he's not done. He's gone and finished business in the Black Stars team. He's playing regularly at Maritzburg United in the PSL. And he looks forward to playing in the Black Stars team once again. He won't make the final squad for the Africa Cup of Nations in Equatorial Guinea in a little over 2 weeks' time. But he looks forward to the team doing very well. He's mentioned that what the team requires or needs to do differently from what we have done from 2014 is to get together more, encourage each other more, and see if results can be improved. We'll do another quick break. When we return, we'll delve into what this team has. The last Africa Cup of Nations, he was there. He won't be there this time. So what the team has, what the team has to work on, because he knows every single player in the current squad he either may have played with or may have seen playing. So he's the best person to talk about each and everybody's quality going into Equatorial Guinea 2015. And for him, we'll look at his aspirations going into 2015 at club level and the Black Stars as well, and his predictions going into the Cup of Nations tournament. Kickoff is proudly sponsored by Bullet Energy Drink, Energy on Target. We're back after this break. Okay, welcome back. We're just sprinting to the end of tonight's edition of Kickoff. I'm sure you're excited about the interview because we've had a number of revelations by a very experienced player for the Black Stars team, John Paintsil, who is home on holidays, plays with Maritzburg in the South African Premier League. He looks forward to making a return to the Black Stars team because he feels that he can contribute some more before he finally retires. He's also revealed that he will play in the Ghana Premier League before he finally retires from playing football actively. We'll also make time in this last section of the interview to talk about the PPKP, is a Paintsil Foundation project, I understand. I'll try and get the real thing. But John Paintsil is looking forward to starting a foundation. The launch is expected in 2015, maybe first quarter of 2015. He'll talk about it. The launch is happening in South Africa. He looks forward to giving back more to society. Anyway, let's get back to John. John, so the Cup of Nations is coming up. Yes, the guys will miss you. You were not with the team during the last World Cup, but I saw the camaraderie. I saw the expressions. I saw the way you guys got together so well last Friday when we were all together watching boxing. Yes, they will miss you, but what have you got to say about this team, and what have you got to say to them as they go to Spain, first of all, for the pre-tournament campaign, and then to Mongomo, where the Black Star team will be based for the tournament?
Yeah, I think it's simple. If you look at the squad that have been assembled, I don't think there's a lot of new faces, because we have the captain, Asamoah Gyan.
Your good friend.
Very good friend. And then we have Dede Ayew. We have Jordan Ayew. Ajman Bedu being around.
Wakaso
and John Boy.
Your boy Jonathan
Mason. Yeah. I mean, these boys are looking forward to make us proud. And I don't think there's a lot of things that's going to change because they know how to do it. What we have to do in camp that will bring the spirit back. For me, I'm saying that, again, it's not about the players not being together. The players are always being together. They love each and everyone. They share jokes and all that. But what they need is they want their father's arms on them. They want the big men who are leading the team to be there, to be in the same place with them, always to talk to them, let the players know what is happening, what has happened to the other teams, whom you are going to play against when you qualify from the next group. I think all this, then the boys will be alert, not to play one game or train and go to your room and don't know what is happening in the other games. You should know that, okay, if I win the group, we're going to meet this team. Or if you're in second, you're meeting this. And players, a great guy, they know which team they want to avoid in the tournament. So all this need to be alert.
We need to do that better than we have
done. We need to do
done.
That. That's the homework for the big men, to put those things in the players' mind. Because we, the players, when we train, we go to our room, we just relax, play our music, and wait for the next game.
Wow.
But the attention has to be there.
The work must be done by the official, though.
Yes.
So is it fair for us to expect that Ghana can win AFCON 2015?
We can.
Can we?
We can, because the kind of squad we have, I don't think these are the players that they have naive in them. They always want to do better. If you look at the way they qualified the country, it was tough group and it was tough moment, and where we struggled from become top in the group. It wasn't easy. Yeah. No team will ever done that, but they managed to do it. And one thing I also want to say is, I think the assistant coach, Master Kurendu, he qualified the team. I think they should give him more power in this tournament,
okay,
especially because he knows the boys, to put those tactics in for them to play. Then it is the new coach, let him be, back him, and for him to give the strong word, the strong tactic, the information. Because the way I saw Wakaso hitting from 50 yards to the pole, if those, that information continue, that's the best information for Black Stars I've ever seen.
Wow.
So if they keep that standard going, the sky will be in our limit.
So yeah. You're saying that Maxwell should have more power because he knows the team better.
Exactly.
So that the new coach, Abraham Grant, will
kind of watch from,
support him.
Yeah, because now it's not now. We don't have time to change things around. The team is there. The tactic, the information is there. I think they should continue that because every football wise man will watch that game, the last game they played in Tamale. You can see there wasn't any chance for opponent to operate from the middle to the defense.
It was a tight
game. So they must keep that thing and go, because if they keep that information, I don't think we will come home with empty-handed.
You know Abraham Grant, he coached your former team, West Ham. Can he do a good job as Black Stars coach?
Yeah, he can, because I even met him when I started my first professional career.
In Israel?
In Israel. He was with the Israel national team. He was coaching the national team, and he was doing an amazing job. And, coming to Ghana with the Black Stars team, the players that we got, and with his experience, I think nothing will go wrong with us. Yeah,
we'll
I think
well.
He's going to do well and then take the team to the next World Cup.
You are falling in love with South African football and the South Africans. The South Africans are in a very tight group, the group of death with Ghana. Can they qualify? How well do you expect them to do?
They will. They will qualify, but Ghana will be on top of the group and South Africa will be in second.
So what it means is that Algeria is everybody's favorite. Algeria won't
Algeria
qualify.
Algeria, Senegal, they should chill.
They should go
they
home,
should
man.
Chill, yeah.
They should chill.
They should chill. They will go. Because I want to see Ghana, South Africa play in the final.
Okay. Yeah. Ghana, South Africa in the final.
Play in final.
That's
wow. What I'm looking forward to.
Okay. John, we need to be wrapping up, but before, you've been giving back to society for many years. Now you want to officially launch your foundation. Tell us about it.
Yeah, I think I did it 2009.
Yeah.
Paintsil Peace Kids Project, PPKP. It's all about what football have taught me is what I want to put in the young ones, age of 8 to 12, teaching them about humility, peace, love, tolerance, and then love, discipline. So, when a child is 8, 12, whatever you say to he or she, keep it into your head. But the adults, they know what is bad, what is good.
Of course.
So whatever you said, it won't go to the head. It can even go to the head.
It will come out.
Come out easily. So, I mean, a child must know how to speak to an elderly man and a woman, or respect their father and all that. So this, I'm using football and education to promote peace among the youth, the young ones, and also give back to the society what the society have given me. So I launched this 2009, but I'm officially going to make it big in South Africa, because I don't want to do it like only Ghana. Okay. But I mean, our continent sometimes also need our help. Yeah, because they look up to us, and whatever we say to them, they take it and then walk through on it. So it's something that also want to give it to our continent.
John, it's always a pleasure having any conversation with you at any time. You have incredible amount of experience playing football, and I listen to you speak about tactics, about conduct and everything. I'm amazed. Do you dream of doing football even after your playing career? There are those who have suggested he can be a good coach, he can be a good football manager. Are you thinking about life after what you are contributing on the pitch?
Yeah, sure. I don't think I'm ready to leave the football system now.
Not yet.
I'm going to be in the system, trying to be...
Will you coach?
I will coach. Wow. Trying to do my coaching course.
So you heard it exclusively here on Metro TV on Kickoff. John Paintsil says he will coach. So you will coach?
I will coach, yeah. I will.
You would want to coach the Black Stars in future, one day?
If the opportunity comes, but yes, I will be.
You would
coach.
Want to coach? Yes. Locally, internationally, anywhere you get the
anywhere
opportunity?
Anywhere I get opportunity.
You will coach? John, thank you very much. Thank you. Thank you. John Paintsil, we've had an interesting conversation with Black Stars defender for many years, played in 6 Africa Cup of Nations tournaments. He's been talking about the Ghana team, the Black Stars, and what the team requires to make a difference in Equatorial Guinea 2015. He says the management of the team must just improve a bit. It's not just about the money, so that we do not record, or we do not, record a recurrence of the Brazil 2014 episodes. We don't look forward to that at all, because he believes it shouldn't be just about the money. We hope you've enjoyed this edition of Kickoff. We brought it to you from the home of John Paintsil, who has allowed us here. Once again, John, thank you very much. Proudly sponsored by Bullet Energy Drink, Energy on Target. My name is Enes Krantin. I'm grateful for your time. Okay, so after a very tough year, a very busy year, 2014, we get together as Metro Sport, and our friends and our loved ones join us as we try to wind down a bit, you know, or unwind, is that how we put it? So we end the year with a small get together. John has given us his word that he will pass by briefly. So we do that later today. We don't need you to actually join us, but you celebrate with us in spirit, wherever you are. Okay, so we're out. We say Happy New Year to you, because this is actually the last edition of Kickoff before we enter into the new year. The next edition is on Friday, by which time we'll be celebrating New Year. Is it Friday? No, on Wednesday, actually. Okay, so we have another edition of Kickoff before the end of the year. We look forward to meeting you and having an interaction again. So enjoy the rest of your evening. Thanks to John Paintsil again, and thanks to Bullet Energy Drink, Energy on Target, for making this possible. Goodbye.